They look as if they're nestling cosily together there, she said after a few moments. That's what I thought. Talk about great minds. I want to keep that cosy, homely look if I can, even if I build new houses. Have you got any ideas about what you might do with the property yet? Presumably you'll have an overall plan. I've been trying not to get too specific till the sale has gone through. I have to admit that I'll be gutted if something goes wrong. He banished that thought and gestured to the gate. Come on, let's trespass. Do you need help climbing over? She proved she didn't by clambering over easily before he did, then standing smiling at him from the other side. No, thank you. Perhaps it's you who needs help, slow coach. So, of course, he had to leap over the gate. Only just managed it, though. He took her hand and led her straight towards the first house. He held his breath for a few seconds as he kept hold of her, but to his delight, she didn't pull away. They stopped to look at the house, and she stared beyond it as well. What's that big mound over there?
I don't know yet. Still to be investigated. I can hardly start digging into it till I own the place, but I must admit I'm curious. I suspect this place was used for secret government purposes during World War II and is only just being returned to public use.
Really? How exciting! I've read about that sort of thing. Never thought I'd see it for myself.
Luckily, someone left a key to this first house so we can go inside.
Fantastic! The key was still there, and he guessed the estate agent didn't even know it existed. He opened the door and flourished a bow.
Will you walk into my parlour, madame?
Oui, s'il vous plaît, monsieur.